Robert T. O'Brien, Mr. O'Brien, Robert, Bob, Dad, Daddy, Grandpa, Great-Grandpa, came into this world July 4th, 1929. From the time we were old enough to know what the 4th of July was about, we were quickly informed that the holiday had nothing to do with this country's independence, but rather, we celebrated because it was my dad's birthday. We had picnics, red, white, and blue cakes, and fireworks, all because of my dad. That's the story he told, and he stuck to it. His childhood was far from perfect, but he made the best of it. From his home in Derby, he'd walk several miles to swim with his buddies in the mighty Housatonic. To make a few dollars, he took a job setting up the pins at a local bowling alley. He went to school and then on to college. It's not surprising to see he was a perfect student with a 4.0 at the University of New Haven. In case you doubt it, we have the report cards to prove it. Yes, he kept his college report cards. He kept a lot of things. He became an engineer, which explains his MacGyver-like tendencies when it came to building or rebuilding just about anything. Eventually, my dad enlisted in the Air Force and spent some time in Korea. After he returned home, he lived an adventurous life, getting his pilot's license and flying small planes, skiing in Colorado, traveling, hitchhiking from state to state, eventually meeting and marrying my mom. With my mom came her mother, my Meme, and her son, my brother Tom. Without hesitation, he took all of us to a brand new house in Prospect. What a great life my mother and father made for us. We never went without. My brother was about 4 or 5 when they moved to Prospect and was heading to kindergarten. Not wanting my brother to have to explain why his last name was different than the rest of the family, or risk being bullied, once again, without hesitation, my dad stepped in and adopted him. On March 1st, 1975, my father woke up to the news on TV that his place of employment, B.F. Goodrich Sponge Rubber Plant in Shelton, Connecticut, had burned to the ground. He'd worked there for 20-plus years, and suddenly he was jobless, with a home, a wife, a son, and my sister and I. With some luck, resilience, and good connections, he started working for the State of Connecticut Office of Policy and Management, from which he retired. After retirement, he and my mom traveled a bit, took some bus trips, drove a few times down to Florida to escape the Connecticut winters. He was a saver, an investor. He was meticulous about the business of the house. Perhaps too meticulous. He saved everything because, say it with me, you never know when you're gonna need it. This past August 30th, he and my mom celebrated 63 years of marriage. Not easy. In fact, it was really hard at times. But my sister and I are forever grateful they stuck it out. There were several moves along the way, out of our home from Prospect, to Cheshire, to Bristol, then Bristol again, and then Bristol once again. When it became clear my folks couldn't live on their own safely, without hesitation, my sister and Peter suggested they come live with them in West Haven. And so for the last 2.5 years, my folks were safe, comfortable, and taken care of. Chris and I will never be able to properly thank you two for everything you did and sacrificed so that they would have a worry-free home. Thank you both. My dad was super smart and could talk about anything because he knew so much about everything. He'd talk about his childhood, his time in the Air Force, his time as a single guy doing what single guys do, his job, the towns in Connecticut it took him to, and politics. So many stories. I'm going to miss those stories. He left this world without regret. There's a song by John Mayer called Say, and he did, we all did. What a great gift that was. Here's a lyric from that song. Have no fear for giving in, have no fear for giving over. You better know that in the end, it's better to say too much than ever to say what you need to say again. Even if your hands are shaking and your faith is broken, even as the eyes are closing, do it with a heart wide open. Say what you need to say. He didn't linger, he would have hated that. He wasn't in pain. He was able to verbalize his feelings, his last thoughts. He was ready. We weren't. But as human beings, we're naturally selfish and we want more time with our loved ones. But he was tired. His body was tired and he needed to rest. And so he did, in peace. And so we're left to grieve, but also to celebrate a life well lived, with more memories than we probably deserve. Sometimes the love you feel from somebody comes through so strongly without even hearing them say, I love you. It can manifest itself with the feelings of security, safety, of being taken care of, strength, and resilience during the tough times, and the lessons you were taught. And that's a lot of love right there. I love you, Dad, and I'm going to miss you.